Now, the United States is under heavy activist pressure at the moment to slash police funding in the wake of high-profile killings by officers. But huge numbers of Americans do say, too, that such political agendas leave them vulnerable to crime. Caleb Maupin picks up the story.
Derek Chauvin is now behind bars, but many Americans don't seem to view him as simply a bad apple. The idea that all police are irredeemable seems widespread among liberal politicians.
It wasn't an accident. Policing in our country is inherently and intentionally racist. No more policing, incarceration, and militarization. It can be reformed.
Congresswoman Ilhan Omar laid out what her agenda is for dealing with the police. First, demilitarize the police. With protests becoming more intense, some argue now is not the time to tie the hands of the officers. Then there's step two, criminalize violence against protesters. Now we can all agree about peaceful protesters, but what about those who burn buildings or engage in property destruction? Next stage, disband and deconstruct police stations. Now, in some parts of the country, they are taking that literally. In Portland, we saw protesters besiege and alight a police union building.
On a grand scale, if it's what they want, which is the reduction or elimination of law enforcement, you're going to get chaos on the streets. You will get survival of the fittest. You will get the American who knows how to defend themselves defending against those who don't. In the lesser of it, you're going to get a complete lack of morale, which is going to lead to just men and women who sit in their cars and collect a paycheck. And the proactive law enforcement, which will be done by presence only, will only completely lead to more crimes. The only people who are going to hurt is the community. So people are not really thinking. They're thinking out of emotion. And the politicians are 100% capitalizing off this. And it's going to be the people who suffer the most.
Now, police chasing down suspects on foot is something you can see in all kinds of TV and movies. But the mayor of Chicago now says it may be time to give that a rest.
No one should die as a result of a foot chase.
Now, of course, this raises some questions. Say a woman's purse is snatched. Do the police then have to call and ask permission before chasing down the perpetrator? Police feel that they are being demonized, and in some cases, they are resigning, saying that the atmosphere is too restrictive. Polls show that a large percentage of Americans do fear that a shortage of police officers could result in chaos nationwide. Los Angeles has seen an 80% increase in shootings. We now have the mayor, a Democrat, calling for an increase in the police budget, reversing the cuts in the police department made at the height of the Black Lives Matter protests last year.
This is purely political for the reason that the systemic racist problem in law enforcement isn't the American police officer. It's the judicial system. It's the politicians who make the laws. It's the prosecutors and the defense attorneys. But nobody wants to talk about that. So the easiest pawn to play in this whole game is the police officer. They're the easiest one to wind up attacking because they're the front line in between the community and ultimately what happens to the community. Remember, the police and the public have a relationship. And if one party is always abused and criticized and the other party refuses to take accountability for what they're doing, you're going to get the one side that just ultimately throws up their arms and walks away. So to be honest, whatever the American police choose to do, if it's stand down or if it's all in all give up, retire, resign, walk away, then no one should really be shocked what's happening. The morale is going to be massively low and you're going to get men and women who are completely unappreciated walking, and good luck to whatever happens in America.
We have all seen the horrendous videos of police shootings. Anger is completely justified, and reform is long overdue. But there's still another question. What will replace them? That is what has many Americans very nervous. Caleb Maupin, RT, New York.